Now I am going to discuss about the centrifugal tension on the belt. Centrifugal tension on the belt. So when the belt is moving through this pulley, there is a centrifugal force which is always acting into the outward direction. So if we consider in that case, when this belt is passing through this pulley, and if we consider this small element of the belt, then we can see that is the centrifugal force Fc which is acting into the outward direction. So Fc is equals to centrifugal force. Okay, and this centrifugal force, there is also a centrifugal tension which is acting into the belt. So Tc is the centrifugal tension. Okay, and T1, T2, that is the tension on the tight side, tension on the slack side, and del theta is a small subtended angle by the tight side tension and slack side tension on the belt. So all the things will be remain same. Now if we consider, that is, if we equating all the forces at horizontal, sorry, at vertical direction, if we equate all the forces into the vertical direction, then summation of Fb equals to zero. It means summation of all the forces in the vertical direction will be zero. So now Fc, that is a centrifugal force, Fc equals to Tc into sin del theta by 2 plus Tc into sin del theta by 2. So Fc equals to 2 into Tc into sin del theta by 2. So from the Fc, that is equals to 2 into Tc into sin del theta by 2. That is the equation number 1. Again we know that is force equals to mass into acceleration. So force equals to mass into acceleration. So if then centrifugal force Fc equals to mass into acceleration. So if here M is the mass of element per unit length, then total mass equals to length of the element into M. The total mass will be length of the element into M. If M is the mass of the element per unit length, then total mass will be length of the element into M. So from here, Fc equals to length of the element. So in this figure, length of the element is R into delta theta. So it will be now here R into delta theta into M into acceleration. So acceleration will be here into acceleration. So FC equals to R into delta theta into M into acceleration equals to omega square into R. That is the acceleration. So acceleration is here omega square into R. So FC equals to R into del theta into M, then omega equals to, for linear velocity, V square by R square into R. Then FC equals to, it will be now R again R. So it will be cancel out. So M into V square into delta theta. So FC equals to M V square into delta theta. So that is the equation number 2. Now, from this equation number 1 and equation number 2, if we equate this equation number 1 and equation number 2, then we will get, it is 2 into TC into sin del theta by 2 equals to M into V square into delta theta. So value of sin del theta by 2 is very small. So sin del theta by 2 equals to del theta by 2 can be written. So now 2 into TC into del theta by 2 equals to M into V square into del theta. So from here 2 will be cancel out, and del theta will be cancel out. So TC equals to M into V square. That is the formula of the centrifugal tension of the belt. It is TC equals to centrifugal tension. Now the total tension at tight side will be T equals to T1 plus TC. That is the another formula. T1 is tension at the tight side. Now again, total tension at slack side will be T equals to T2, that is the tension at the slack side, and it will be added with the centrifugal tension. So total tension at the slack side will be, this is the TS and this is TT. So these are the formulas.